Welcome to Beast Valley TV. My name is Lavenia Shaw. I'm from Suva, Fiji. Our topic today is the 2300 days prophecy. What is the 2300 days prophecy? Where does it occur? Is it important to Christians? So let us discover where it is in the scripture. Before we move on to our topic, the 2300 days prophecy, let's review a few things. So let's start with the King Nebuchadnezzar's dreams. I know we have already touched this in the prophecy, the starting of this, the image. As you can see, I have included the date of the reign of each king. The interpretation of the dream went on to mention the fact that other inferior kingdoms would succeed that of Nebuchadnezzar. In Daniel 3:1, it appears that the king was not satisfied to know that his kingdom would pass away. So he made an image completely of gold. He tried to destroy the prophecy. And you know what happened to him? He lost his mind and was banished from the palace to eat grass for 7 years. So it is so serious to suffer from pride and rebel against God. Let's establish the starting point of this 2300 days prophecy. Ezra 6:14, the completion of the temple. In the sixth year of Darius, King Darius was born in 550 BC to 486 BC. He was the king of Persia from 522 to 486 BC. The third day of Adar is our March, the last month of the Jewish year. The sixth year of Darius was from 516 to 515 BC. Daniel 9:25, the beginning of the 2300 days prophecy. Daniel 8:14, the beginning of the judgment. Daniel 9:25 also is the beginning of the 70 weeks prophecy. Cyrus issued the first decree in Ezra 1:1, in Ezra 6:1, and 2 Chronicles 36:22-23. Darius issued the second decree. Artaxerxes issued the third decree. By using Daniel 9 prophecy and the date 457 BC as the beginning, it reaches exactly to the baptism of Jesus. In fact, Daniel 9:24 suggests that the events which took place within the 70 weeks sets God's seal of approval on the whole prophecy. They show that the prophecy was divinely given and thus dependable. No other date begins to satisfy the demands of the prophecy. We use Ezra 7, the decree issued in the seventh year of Artaxerxes, which reaches to the baptism of Jesus. Packer and Dabbestein's books, Babylonian Chronology from 626 BC to 75 AD, cataloged thousands of clay tablets dating the reigns of kings. The authors also employed the dates of eclipses. These astronomers confirmed the dates of these eclipses. The seventh year of Artaxerxes began in 458 BC and extended into 457 BC. Thus, the departure of Ezra for Jerusalem and his arrival fall within 457 BC. Ptolemy's canon agrees with this date. Claudius Ptolemy's was a Greek and also a Roman astronomer from 90 to 168 AD. Ptolemy's canon is a dated king list of kings used by ancient astronomers as a convenient means to date astronomical phenomena from 747 BC to 535 BC, as and is in harmony with other historical events. The judgment begins in 1844 is based upon a day for a year interpretation of the 2300 days. The evidence used is found in Numbers 14:34 and Ezekiel 4:6. Other evidence comes from Genesis 29:24, when Laban requires an additional 7 years of work in contract for Rachel's hand in marriage, calling it a week. We have established the starting date for the 2300 days prophecy as 457 BC and now come to its end in 1844. When Daniel was told that the sanctuary would be cleansed in Daniel 8:14, we have also described the Day of Atonement as conducted in the earthly sanctuary, where the high priest was in the most holy place to cleanse the sanctuary. The declaration made in Daniel 8:14 refers to the sanctuary in heaven, where Jesus, our high priest, is cleansing the sanctuary. In Hebrews 3:1, Hebrews 4:14, and Hebrews 8:1-2. The first angel's message of Revelation 14:7 is a call to judgment, a call addressed to the entire world, meaning there is no select group. There is also a call to acknowledge the Creator with the suggestion of a true Sabbath. In Revelation 14:12, it is declared, "Here is the patience of the saints." From the Strong's Concordance 5602, meaning in the Spirit. 5281, meaning waiting. And 5278, meaning remain. During the Day of the Atonement, the congregation were to gather around the sanctuary and pray and afflict their souls, asking God to accept their high priest. Today is no different. By faith, we are together around the sanctuary, praying and afflicting our souls that we may be justified, never sinned, covered by the righteousness of Jesus. This is the righteousness by faith. In 1844, that is when the judgment began. We are in the judgment at the moment. The judgment going on right now in the most holy place is for the repentant sinners. What about the unrepentant sinners? The Bible gives us the answer, and we don't need to speculate on that. Using the same day for a year principle, the world has 6 days of a week in which to exist. In 2 Peter 3:8 and verse 7 states that the heavens and the earth, which now exist, are reserved unto fire until the day of judgment. In other words, God has given this world 6,000 years of probation and the other day of the week, or 1,000 years, is for the second judgment, which will take place in heaven, which is in Revelations 21:6. After the judgment is completed in heaven, the decision to cleanse the earth is implemented. Whosoever was not found written in the Lamb's book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Revelation 20:25. After the first judgment is completed and probation for the people of God has closed, the seven last plagues begin in Revelation 16 in the form of seven vials. Probation for the world has closed, and nobody is now in the most holy place to plead their case. Revelation 15:8. This time is also called the time of Jacob's trouble, in which a death decree will be issued against the people of God. Jeremiah 37. But he shall be saved out of it. The four angels of Revelation 7:1-3 will hold the winds of strife until Jesus finishes his ministry in the most holy place, and then the angels will release the winds of strife. The plagues will follow, and this enrages the wicked who blame the plagues on God's people. A death decree is issued, and this time is called Jacob's trouble. Revelation 13:15. Let's look at the times of the Gentiles found in Luke 21:24. After the destruction of Jerusalem in 70 AD, the times of the Gentiles began, and Jerusalem to be trodden down of the Gentiles. Those who occupied Palestine were the Romans, the Saracens, Norsemen, Turks, and British until 1844, when the judgment began. This period of 1,800 years was the period between the destruction of Jerusalem and its temple and the beginning of the times of the end. This period refers to the Gentiles holding the church of God in the place of the Jews. In Acts 13:46, and Acts 18:6, it says, I quote, "Lo, we turn to the Gentiles," by Paul and Barnabas. Let me go back to our questions from the beginning. I've already explained the 2,300 days prophecy to you, from its establishment until our present day. The judgment is now going on, and it will finish shortly. But the important thing is to remember is when the judgment finishes, probation will close. And as Christians, we should know all of these events from the Bible, and we should be following the movements of our high priest by faith. Now is the time to make your calling and your election sure. You've just heard the 2,300 days prophecy, and coming next is the 70 weeks prophecy, which include the stoning of Stephen as a landmark or a turning point in the history. Thank you. We hope that you will learn a few things from this topic, and if you have any questions or any comments or even criticism, you can contact the number on the screen for more information. Thank you. Vinakavakalevu Medawase.